She was the messenger of Sauron, and was wont to fly in vampire's form to Angband, and her great fingered wings were barbed at each joint's end with an iron claw. What are vampires in Tolkien's legendarium? These mysterious creatures are only briefly mentioned, but that just adds to the interest in what they could be. The word vampire will invoke images of blood-sucking humans transforming into bats or other creatures. We think of sunlight, stakes, and running water. In Tolkien's works, vampire does not seem to share that same meaning. Our best examples of vampires would be forms taken by Sauron and his messenger in the First Age, Thuringwethil. When it comes to the stories themselves, vampires do not play any major role. They aren't really mentioned after the First Age. This could be explained by speculating that they could have been destroyed after Morgoth's defeat in the War of Wrath, or that there was just no role for them to play in The Hobbit or The Lord of the Rings. Perhaps they were few in number in the first place. Bats do exist and are referenced in The Hobbit, and it is possible that they are just similar creatures to these great creatures of old, more powerful beings taking the shape of great bats. This would be much like werewolves, fell beasts inhabited by spirits that Sauron was said to imprison in their bodies. This didn't stop ordinary wolves from existing. Could the relationship between bats and vampires be something similar to wolves and werewolves? Sauron's dark power at work. Sauron himself takes the form of a vampire as he escapes the elf Lúthien and the hound of Valinor, Húan. After his humiliating defeat, he is released after yielding authority of the Isle of Werewolves, Tol-in-Gaurhoth. Then Sauron yielded himself, and Lúthien took the mastery of the isle and all that was there, and Húan released him, and immediately he took the form of a vampire, great as a dark cloud across the moon, and he fled, dripping blood from his throat upon the trees, and came to Tower Nufún, and dwelt there, filling it with horror. Some may associate Sauron's form here with a traditional vampire, due to him dripping blood from his throat. This would be blood dripping due to the injury sustained from the tight grip of the Hound of Valinor, who held him so tight that even by shifting shape, Sauron could not be free of him. It seems that the term vampire is speaking of a large, monstrous and hideous bat form used by Sauron. The second figure is the Woman of Secret Shadow, Thuringwethil. She's a very minor character, with next to no detail for any sort of analysis. We know that she is Sauron's messenger, and was most likely killed by Húan or the collapse of Minas Tirith in Tol Sirion. We know she was defeated as Lúthien takes her form to make her way to Angband with Beren to achieve the quest of the Silmaril. But Lúthien heard his song, and she sang in answer as she came through the woods unlooked for. For Húan, consenting once more to be her steed, had borne her swiftly hard upon Beren's trail. Long he had pondered in his heart what counsel he could devise for the lightening of the peril of these two whom he loved. He turned aside, therefore, at Sauron's isle as they ran northward again, and he took thence the ghastly wolf helm of Draugluin and the bat fell of Thuringwethil. She was the messenger of Sauron and was wont to fly in vampire's form to Angband, and her great feathered wings were barbed at each joint's end with an iron claw. Clad in these dreadful garments, Húan and Lúthien ran through Tower Nufún, and all things fled before them. With the ability to change forms much as Sauron did, it may be that like her master, Thuringwethil was a Maia. Other Maiar took monstrous forms. such as the case of the Balrogs, and it is possible that this Maia took on the form of a giant bat creature, able to serve Sauron through flight. Thus the name vampire may be used to just distinguish these creatures from ordinary bats. They would have been far greater, more terrifying and powerful than ordinary bats. As mentioned earlier, this could be a similar distinction shared between wolves and werewolves. It could be though that Thuringwethil is a remnant of the earliest versions of Tolkien's legendarium. She appears in writings found in the Book of Lost Tales, when the creation of myth was more important than the detailed explanations we were given in later writings. The legendarium at this time was quite different from what it would become in many places. Strange creatures existed, and Thuringwethil could be one of them, with no clear explanation offered. More magic, myth, and legend than origin stories. Tolkien could have offered no explanation even if asked. It just so happens that her place in the legendarium can be explained by placing her within Sauron's order, even if we don't know this for a fact. Soon, actual darkness was coming into a stormy sky, while still the great bats swirled about the heads and ears of elves and men, or fastened vampire-like on the stricken. We are left not knowing whether vampires are a type of bat, a name for creatures taking on great bat shapes, such as we see with Sauron and Thuringwethil, or if some type of creature called a vampire did exist, and Sauron merely took on that shape. For me, it seems like it is a name given to the shape, though references to bats attacking in vampire-like fashion in The Hobbit perhaps add to the mystery of these already mysterious creatures. If you enjoyed this video or the other content on my channel, I hope you will take a moment to subscribe. Please feel free to leave suggestions and comments for any content you'd like to see in this series or any others on the channel.